So this is a game called Black and White. I don't know if you ever heard of it, but here's a classic entry if anybody remembers this. Swish it around if you want. It's just amazing. Yeah, this is Windows 10, by the way. I did get it working with there's a patch, a community patch for this game. You still have the original copy, pirate it, whatever. It's still playable. Fantastic game. There's a controversy with this game too. You guys can look that up on you, or I'm sorry, not on YouTube, on Google. There might be some YouTube videos on it. I can't say for sure. Haven't checked. But this is probably one of my favorite games I've ever played. You basically get to be God. You could like pick little people up and toss them, or you can help them. You can water their crops and. Basically, the game's premise is you have to fight another god because he's trying to destroy the ability for any other type of gods to come into the world and contend with his godliness. He wants to be the one god. Go figure. It's like the same battle on the real world. So anyway, the game doesn't have wonderful graphics, but it's really awesome that a game that came out, we're talking 20 years ago. This is a 20-year-old game. And I've played a lot of games. And this one still beats the crap out of most of the games I play. Here I am, anyway, back to this game travel here. This is after the first map. The first map is kind of irritating. Well, it's teaching you everything. It's showing you how to throw rocks. It's showing you how to pick a person up. It's not a lot of fun. it's more of, trudging through how to figure out how the game works. I'm sure in the second map when I go through the portal, there will be some more training, but it won't be as severe. Of course, I get a phone call when I don't need it. All right, anyway, ditching the phone call. Without further ado, I light my game smoke and we shall continue the game. Go through the portal. Right, so basic ideas on this game is this little red zone. This is your boundary. See, within the red zone, if you look at the map, you see my red zone nearly encompasses the entire island. The only way you make that grow is to get greater influence, and I'll explain on how to do that later. But inside your influence zone, you're allowed to pick up trees, replant them wherever you like. Could find random creatures like these horses, and I'm gonna take a couple of these horses because I don't know if they're gonna have horses in the next map. Obviously, if you take two of them, that will make more than one horse, nature, whatever. See, that's the sound that I'm very near my zone. You have a little bit of influence outside your zone, but not very much. So I was over here, and yes, here are the horses again. I'm gonna toss another one through the hole. I'm just taking a quick peek to see if I could find any more types of creatures, because it's kind of cool with this game. You go close enough to the coast, you'll find turtles. I mean, you'll find an abundance of creatures. This is well before Unity ever came out, I know I've been playing a lot of games based on Unity lately, Subnautica being one of them. And this game had its issues. Oh, believe me, like you get too far, or you have too many followers or worshippers, so the game calls them. It'll just start to crash. I'm sure it'll do the same thing if I do it now. But here's an example of what you could do real quick. I stuck one tree in there, and since there's water there, it'll continuously grow. So if you have a civilization that needs wood, you just plant the water in the tree, and or you can water it where it stands, and it'll create these mini trees. You see these little mini guys? Oh, see, look, and I run into the turtles. Beautiful. And here's a special mushroom that I actually really could use. But yeah, they grow up into these big guys. You could take these big guys out and put them on the side, being fully grown. It's so to make room for the next set of these little guys. Alright, so... Oh, I can pick up a turtle, yay! Okay, so I'm gonna take this turtle and throw him through a hole that he never wishes he... Oh my god. Lightning! But yeah, there he goes. There's a portal. Mr. Turtle's going through. So... You also have a conscience, an evil, and a good god to help you along your process. I never really listened to him because, darn it, I've been playing this game a while. A long while. But it's still cool. They can help you, give you ideas. If you find this game and start playing it, you'll love it. Maybe, you know, if you're into this kind of stuff. And, you know, you can be an evil god, you can be a good god. It all depends on what you want. Okay, so I can pick up the mushroom caps. These are supposed to be a game secret. If you hit C, it'll find your creature. You get a creature. You pet him in the stomach. He will eat. Mushroom you give him. There he goes. Yeah, I'm getting hit really hard. See, he's trying to put the fires out. I taught him how to do some spells. That's one thing really great about your creature. If, say, a village is outside of your influence ring, you can't influence them and change their minds about who they're going to follow, but you can with the creature, because the creature can do magic outside of your zone, since he's an independent force altogether. So, it's really, really good to have a large creature. The bigger the creature is, the more influence that it will raise. You see the environmental sound, the music, it's just great. So my whole goal right now is to pretty much go through portal. And this is it, obviously, right here. I didn't want to go through there just yet. I just wanted to explain a little bit about this game and what you can do, what you can't do. You know, here's some more horses. There should be cows, and I mean, I've seen leopards and all kinds of interesting creatures in this game. Of course, there's like sheep and pigs and like your basic creatures, but some of the creatures you find in this game, you really don't expect to see. Oh yeah, along with being a god, you can smash things. You know, the world is destroyable. You can't really terraform. You can smash the hell out of it. So what's happened here is that there was a very large creature who was formerly the god. His name is Nemesis. And he struck him down with lightning and killed him. Because he taught my creature about how to become a more powerful god to secure your power. So he was killed in order to teach my tiny creature. As you can see, he's quite a bit larger than my creature here. And look at him, he's a mere kitten. Ooh, he was struck by lightning too. There he's healing himself, which is a necessity. Alright, little more explanation in the game. There are three leashes. He has one on right now. You just press L and you'll see it's a rainbow leash, and that doesn't make him gay, sorry. People of that genre, lifestyle. No, this is just a leash of compassion. This brown roped one is your standard leash to walk around him. Also, it is used as a teaching tool. He won't learn unless you have that on. And the third leash is the leash of anger. If you wish him to be angry and attack things, you would change that leaf. Now, something really cool, if you look at the lower right-hand corner of the screen here, you'll see that you can do gestures. I have not seen this in games for a long time, where I could change his leash just by moving the mouse. Here, I'm going to change it again so he doesn't destroy things. Give him the leash of compassion, or we can give him the leash of learning. So just to give you an idea, you're supposed to be able to wiggle this off. I just unleash him with the L key. That's alright. With the leash also, you can pull him around. Like, you want him to go that way, he'll go that way. You want him to go that way, he'll come this way. Yeah, see? Alright, so this is the game world here on this plane. There are many planes to this game. Like, as you can see, that portal is portal to another plane, a whole nother level or island or continent, however you want to put it. I don't know if it'd be a continent since only two towns really fit here, but island will do. So the whole idea is to go through the portal, so let's do that. There's enough destruction here. My creature's ready to go, so let us go. All the people and creatures I threw through it.
I feel all inside out.
Ugh. Oh yeah, what a butt!
Look, someone's approaching.
I greet you as one god to another. I am Khazar. It was I who provided the vortex to save you from Nemesis. Please, come with me. I need your help. In return, I will help you. My very existence is threatened by Lethys, another god from the Snowy Realm and an ally of Nemesis. But you and I together can turn the tide of this war. There is much to do, though. Firstly, you need to build up a village and look after your worshippers. I'll take you back to your village and place down scaffolds for you from my village's workshop.
That's how you build, through scaffolding.
Yep. These create blueprints which indicate to your people what to build and where you want it. I will give you my finest builder. This is a disciple who works single-mindedly. You can create your own disciples by placing people at the locations of the jobs you wish them to do.
Can select what, if they're breeders, farmers, foresters, it's pretty
cool.
Here
is some food, wood and water for your tribe to help you start. I must leave to defend my realm, but I shall return when I can.
Khazar has provided us with so much. He's a true ally.
He's desperate, that's what he is.
Let's get our village built.
Yeah, and we gotta get disciples working there.
Alright, well, these are most of the people I threw through the portal. As you can see, plenty of wood has been thrown over. You can't waste this stuff. You really need it. excuse me. Okay, so there are several scaffolds that have been put down, which is my village center where food goes. Oh, wow, he's building homes as well. This is excellent start. I can get right down to what this is about. So, alright, that is a special looking character for sure, so that must be the single-minded builder, because normally your people kind of look like this. So, let's grab him and give him a job. Make him another builder.
Disciple builder.
That way, it will build much quicker. So, since we are in need of wood there... there they are. So, as being a god, you can do miracles. These aren't the miracles that you can use right away. Yes, they are, but normally you would use prayer power to induce such a miracle. So, these are miracle bubbles. These are like little gift miracles without the ability to do them. So I'm going to drop the wood miracle right here. And you see 20 belief? That's my power growing there. More belief you have, the larger your boundary is. What's strange here is it's not showing my boundary. I believe that is because I don't have...
I'm fighting for the land you see below you.
There's my creature trying to grow trees. But, I've not established yet, so I'm sure my boundary zones will be shown then. Okay, here we go. There's an indication that my boundary is about here. Now, when the whistle ends, that's when you can't touch stuff. If I wanted to steal
your
this
temple
tree...
temple is built. Excellent.
Alright, now you can see my boundary line. Pretty cool, right? Here's a town we need to take over right away. But we still have to establish ourselves here. Without establishing ourselves, we're wasting our time. Hear the heartbeat? It's faint, but it's there. That's pretty much the status of your... everything, your whole entire status here. So, as your belief grows, so as does your temple. And you don't need any more wood for it to grow. That is, unless you build a miracle, but miracles come much later. So here, I'm still attempting to get my prayer center here. You know what? I'll just drop this right here. Let's make some...
Disciple Builder.
Couple builders. It looks like we don't have very many girls. There we go.
Disciple Breeder.
There you go, lover boy. Go get her. Alright, so let's make a few more breeders while we're at it.
Disciple Breeder.
Male and a female breeder. There you go. So they will breed, those guys will build. These guys still need more wood. That's alright. See, the great thing is the people will literally carry the wood from the piles. And they will take them to whatever job site. The best thing to do is to have this village center, or... I know it's not a workshop because... it holds food and wood. So I'd call it like City Hall or something, or maybe even the prayer totem would be City Hall. I'm not really sure. But what I don't like to do is rip up trees, but sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do. It's only because I'm trying to build this a little bit quicker for you guys to move this along, because this is a slow-moving game. But I'm going to build this, and I'm going to take over one village, and I'll end the video just so you guys get a quick peek at the game. Ah, yes, let's not forget
about
farming.
Disciple Farmer.
Farming's very, very important, and obviously because we all need food, right? Villagers need food. So, the maximum resolution that this game will operate at is 1080.
Good. You have built much, but there is more for you to construct.
Constantly bugs the hell out of me. Okay, so now that my totem is built, it tells me what miracles that I have that I can use. One wonderful miracle here is the water miracle. You can use this miracle to water crops, put out fires, a lot of things you can do. You can just use it to rise belief if you like. You know, it's very easy to do. Wood, that's pretty obvious for building, other things like that. And here's a food miracle, which is also really self-explanatory. I still need 500 wood for this joint over here. Alright, now they'll finish that. We're probably going to need to put some food in there because that's what should be done. See the 52 number that popped up? That is how much belief you get. And you can build it up to thousands. But if you don't feed them, your people will die. Yeah, we need this built up. Come on, guys. Alright, so I have a few water miracles here. Let's make ourselves a little briar patch. Alright, so got some of those fields going, and the farmers will definitely take advantage of that. Another wonderful thing in this game is you can... Yeah, they will
check
cry about
stuff. Check your village's desire flag. People need stuff badly.
There's healing, and yes, this right here, the flags tell you
food.
What the people need, obviously. And here's expansion desire. That
must
is
build homes.
The request for homes. I'll pull all the wood from all the areas. Put them all in one place. Once you do that, they'll all grab it from the same spot. And obviously the best spot would be the town center, which I call the town center. And they will have enough wood and some food. And they still need food pretty terribly, so let's inject as much food as we can. I'd have sworn I threw a lot of food over. I'm looking for where they may have ended up. As you can hear, the heart is still beating nice and softly. Wonderful. Okay, so here's a nice little amount of food that came over. See, not everything that you throw through the portal will come back. Some of it gets tossed into the ocean, which is unfortunate, but once it goes there... You're screwed. See, wow, food, you know. Oh, here's a great pile of food, 1,000. That'll help them a ton. Well, they got that food. Wonder if there's anything else that got tossed around. Well, doesn't really look like much. That's all right. We'll just drop it right in there. Maybe they'll be a little happier. Alright, now I'm gonna start with something here that we need. Oh, that's gonna be a lesson then. We need as many farmers as we can get right now. Well, that's okay, so that's a female, we'll make her a breeder.
Disciple breeder.
More people and more influence. The more people and the more belief you have, increase your influence ring. So, my guess here is he's going to explain prayer and building. So, here we go.
Consolidate your position by building more. I have given you an expert builder of worship sites. This building is of great importance. I shall return once you have finished building the worship site.
Ha! Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy! Are we gonna cause some havoc now?
Hey!
havoc? No, but it will be good to cast lots of lovely miracles when we need them.
Cool. There's a sheep, a cow, a horse, two horses. Oh, excellent. So we're going to have horses and pigs here because I threw them over, which is a great thing. Looks like one... Oh, the two turtles made it too, so we will also have turtles. That is beautiful. And they might already even be here, but some islands, they don't have certain animals, you know, so... They won't, reproduce, and then, you know, because they're really good sources of food. But you really don't want to use the animals as much. At least I don't like to. Here they are building the site at which they will worship and give me the power to create these miracles without being confined to using these bubbles. But there you go, I healed a couple of builders because they tend to get exhausted. But what you're basically supposed to do is pull this totem up. And more people, as much as they come, will go to your temple worship site. And when they do that, they will give you prayer power, and then you'll be able to create your own miracles. You'll be able to do it by hand gesture, like this. That's alright. I don't need it. Yet. So, let's take a peek over here. Oh, it is finished. All right.
The power you wield grows.
So we'll click on this scroll and explain it to us a little more.
Your worship site is built. Now let me teach you how to create miracles. Your people will worship you at the temple. To send them there, you must raise the totem at the village center. You move the hand over the totem. Then you hold down the action button to grab the totem.
I hate the tutorials.
You move the hand up and down to raise and lower the totem. I've raised the totem, so... The higher you raise the totem, the more people from your village will go to worship you. Now come and look at your followers.
You have to give them food here, too.
They are dancing, worshiping you. This gives you power.
Freaky, right? Maybe. I still think it's cool. It's got a great idea. There were a few sequels to this game, but this one is my favorite. There's so many fun things you can do with this particular game that you can't do in any other game I've ever seen.
These are the miracles that your people offer you. The miracles of grain, wood, and water. To activate one, grab the miracle
Shut
with the
up!
Action button, and it will be charged by your worshippers.
We know.
You'll see
I
the
know.
Energy rings flowing into your hand. When the miracle is charged, it appears in your hand, and you are ready to cast the miracle. Remember, worshipping comes at a cost. The needs of your worshippers can be seen on these flags. So, it's good to satisfy these needs and keep your villagers in good health.
Okay.
I'll leave you now to experiment with miracles and expand your influence by growing your village.
Why, thank you. Alright, so... The glowing is how much power that you have built.
Miracle wood.
Now I can freely create miracles.
Must build homes.
Okay, yeah, see, it looks as though that everything is being built for me here, which is okay. This, I believe, is a child rearing center, so that when your villagers have children, they have a place to, it's like a daycare, you know, so they can go to work. Yeah, it's pretty cool that you can crack rocks in half if you want to. Sometimes you'll even find stuff in the rocks. It all depends. Or you can take the rocks and toss them through a village to gain belief, which I will demonstrate right here. Oh, see, look how close I have. I'll just toss that and... But I didn't damage anything. So I need 300 belief over there in order to take that village over. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use some of these little miracles here that we have left. Yeah, this I should keep. Now their wood requirement has fallen. So I'm going to use a water miracle.
Must build homes.
And I could pretty much shower down on anybody. As the whistle runs out, there goes your influence. So that gave me about 50 belief or so. You can go in and destroy them into submission. I don't really like to do that, but you can. A cool thing to do if you don't want to do any damage is you could take a tree and just toss it through the village. People, they'll just freak out about it. Well, they kind of did. That's not working. So we will try. Try a food miracle.
Miracle food.
Yeah, see, that gave me 13 belief. That's not really doing very much. But I have to keep very, very close eye on their needs.
Miracle food.
Need food.
If you don't feed them, they will die.
Worshippers want food.
See, he was talking about the rings. They will become faster and faster until it is ready. Obviously, explain that to you. But you know, I don't know if you guys.
Miracle food.
Here it is in practice. They got a large food requirement here. Let's give them some more food before they start dying off.
Miracle food.
The lower your population is, the less influence and the smaller your temple will become. So right now, I really don't need a large amount of worshippers there. Can drop that down to about maybe 5% of the people. So what'll happen is that'll cause a lot of people to go home.
Worshippers need food.
Well, they have food, so shut up.
Worshippers need food.
Oh, they already ate it all, pigs. Bastards! Unfortunately, I have to wait for this. Another neat thing that you could do is you can create ambassadors. Oh no. Give me that. Give me that miracle. Almost there. Here we go.
Come on. Want food.
Miracle food.
Sometimes I wonder where it's supposed to exactly go. Sometimes I like just dropping it there. You know, I don't see a pot. Oh, there. Okay. It goes there. That makes a lot more sense. See, because the flag went away. Okay, so they have enough to build this particular building.
We must build homes.
Here, little signpost. So here, this explains what the scaffolding does. You basically just build scaffolds. Okay, so then this is the This is a building, a scaffold creation building, like a, I don't know, workshop, woodhouse, whatever. So, three scaffolds make a civic building, which a civic building would be, say, a worshiping deal or a town hall over there or another home. So, let's experiment here with building some homes. Oh, wait, there's a gold story scroll. Oh, no. We gotta listen
must
to crap.
Build homes.
Kazar sent me. I can help you build your settlement up. People are sleeping outdoors as they don't have enough buildings to live in.
This game 20 years ago rivals the
this
games
is
they
the
make
workshop.
Today.
I make scaffolding here. It allows you to
them.
Decide when new buildings should be constructed. If you can supply me with enough wood, I can build a scaffold so that you can plan more houses.
Alright, so... Hey, can we go away, gold story scroll? Oh, they're not... I don't think they're done with the building yet. Oh, they are. Okay, so you basically have to dump wood on them, and then they'll build scaffolds. That's the deal.
Homes.
Yeah, I can hear you, but let's do something a little more fun first. Where's our influence ring now? Okay. I'm literally at the center of town. Let's scare the hell out of them. Aw, it was a poor kid.
Make
too.
Them suffer!
There you go. Now I got the town, and my influence ring has increased quite a bit.
Yes, I knew you'd be a wise choice to ally with.
So they blow off firecrackers, and they're happy they found a new god. Woo! You know, it's pretty cool. The good thing about taking over these villages is they give you new miracles. Now I have the miracle of heal. So... this is just an introduction into this game. If you guys want me to make more videos on it, I'd gladly post them up. Here is a graveyard. That is another civic building that does require building after a period of time. But just to give you an idea, also another way to take over a village slowly is you can grab somebody, take them over to the next village, and make them a disciple.
Disciple missionary.
Now he's a missionary, and they're gonna slowly build a belief for you in the next village. As you can see here, I can pick up a rock and throw it. Nobody seems to notice that, so. Great thing to do is where there's people, toss it, and then belief will just. It'll just grow pretty much by itself. Uh-oh. See, now I just damaged something. That's not nice. Well, I don't own their settlement. Ooh, they have teleportation miracle and fireball. See, now, with fireball and teleportation... that would be one heck of an improvement, and I would be able to do a heck of a lot more. Alright, let's pull a tree and supply them with enough to build a scaffold.
Give me a little more time and I'll turn the wood into scaffolds.
That would build one scaffold for a small home. I would very much like to have two scaffolds. Like I said, I don't like pulling up trees, but I'll do it for you guys anyway. Just
so
that
it looks like your scaffolding is ready. We just need to move it to an area where we want it built. We need to place a scaffold down on the ground.
Shut up, I know that. Let me explain things. Okay, so I've got two scaffolds
when you're
ready
happy
to go.
With its location and angle, click the action button.
There. Now they're combined.
This is such a worthwhile cause.
That's
plenty
two
homes to be built for the homeless.
There is another way to solve this homeless problem.
Oh, yes?
Yeah! Kill him!
It's actually true. You can, if you have too high of a population, murder your disciples' homes. As if you look, trying to build a huge house, it's only given me this selection. So, well, we'll build one more home closer to we want a big house. There. Now the people will just bring wood over and it'll continue to be built. So anyway, once again, this is Black Hole here. Subscribe if you want. If you want to see more of this game. It's hard to find. It's a rarity. It's one of my favorite games. If you guys want to see more of it, just let me know. Otherwise, subscribe. Give me thumbs up, whatever the hell you want to give it. Just let me know what you think. All right, folks. Have a nice day.